Hey everybody, what's up? It's Rob Dodson here from the Google Developer Relations team. And in this series, we're going to be covering the basics of using Polymer's core icon elements. In lesson one, we'll look at how you can use core icon to get your very first image up on screen. And in lesson two, we'll look at how you can load in a custom icon set of your own making. But let's start with lesson one, how to get your very first icon up on screen. So just about every website is going to need to use icons at some point. So, you know, looking at the Polymer site, we've got the search icon here. We've got a few buttons with icons. We've even got some of these arrows down here that include it. And so what we're going to do today is we're going to look at how you can use the core icon element to get a single icon up on screen, maybe something like a letter, and how you could use maybe the core icon element set to load in a default set of icons. That'll make it just a lot faster for you to get some icons displaying on screen. So starting us off, let's first look at how we can get a core icon up on screen. So here, I'm assuming it's in Bower Components, and I've just imported its definition. And once I drop my core icon on the page, I can give it a source attribute and point to some image file that I've got saved somewhere. So here, I'm loading this Android icon. But I could, you know, refer to just about any image format that I want. It doesn't have to necessarily be SVG. It could be like a PNG, a GIF, WebP, something like that. But typically, we prefer and we recommend that you use SVG, primarily because it's a vector format, which means it's not going to lose any quality as you're scaling the image up or scaling it down. Now, you might look at this and think it's not really a significant improvement over using something like the image tag. We've still got to refer to some source attribute that's some file that we've got saved on disk, and that doesn't really save us that much time. So to make things easier on us, we can actually include a default icon set and pull our icons from there. So let's take a look at that. So here I'm including core icons instead of just the core icon element. Note the S here. This is plural. And what that's doing is it's going to still load in the definition for core icon, but it's also going to pull in a default icon set. So now I can just say, hey, I want an icon. I want it to be an Android icon. And it's going to load that from my default icon set. There's a bunch of icons in the set, so I could, you know, throw in a cloud icon. I could throw in a Polymer icon. In fact, if you want to take a look at the full suite of icons that are in the default set, you can follow this link right here. I'll take you to this page. There's tons of great stuff that you can look at and throw into your site or application. All right, now we got something showing up on screen. The next thing we got to do is we got to give it some size and we got to style. So I'm going to just apply some CSS classes here to change the size of my icon. And that's so I can override the CSS that gives the icon its default sizing of 24 pixels. So this icon smaller class, for instance, has a width and height of 20 pixels. That's going to give me this guy down here. It's much smaller. Likewise, using icon larger, width and height 90 pixels gives me a much larger icon. And now to style this thing, it's super simple. We're just going to give it a color using the color property in CSS. Set it equal to this bright green value, and we'll get this guy over here on the right. So that about covers the basics of getting our core icon up on screen. Let's switch over to our code editor now, and we can actually see if we can get this to display in our browser. All right, so the first thing we need to do is we need to make sure we're loading the platform. So we're going to pull in Bower Components, platform/platform.js. That's going to give us access to all the web component technology, so we can start using things like HTML imports. So then we're just going to write out an import, and we're going to pull in that core icons definition. So we're going to say core icons, coreicons.html. Note we're using core icons, the plural one here, because that's going to give us access to the default icon set. And it's also going to load in the definition for core icon for us. So then we can just write out a core icon tag and give it an icon attribute. And we'll point it at that Android icon that we've been using so far. Save this and go to our browser and refresh the page. And up there in the top left corner, we've got a little bitty icon. So the next thing I want to do is I want to give this icon a size. So I'm going to start to write out a style tag. And oh, I got to remember, I got to add a class to my icon element. So I'm going to go down there. And we'll give it a class of icon larger. So that's so our CSS has greater specificity. So we're going to use that icon larger class. And we'll set the width and height to 200 pixels. It's kind of a big icon, but that way everyone on the video can see it. So go back and refresh the page. And we've got this much bigger icon. Now, if you go and check out the Polymer documentation for the core icon element, you can actually scroll down the page, and you'll see that there is a link down here at the bottom, which will point to the core icons element set. So you can actually browse through all the icons that are available in this default set. So scrolling around, I can see that, you know, there's this cool cloud icon. And if I want, I can just copy its name, go back to my code editor, paste that into my icon attribute. Then when I refresh the page, I've got this cooler cloud icon that I can work with. And, you know, going back, if I want, maybe I can grab like this drive icon, drop that into my icon attribute, refresh the page, and I've got the drive logo. Sweet. But I want to stick with that Android icon because we've been working with it for a bit now. So I'm going to put Android back in there. And the last thing I want to do is I want to give it a color. So over my CSS, I'm just going to use a color property. And I'm going to set it to this cool bright green hex value. So save that, go back and refresh the page. And I've got this bright green Android icon. So that about covers the basics of using the core icon elements. In the next video, we're going to look at how you can load in additional icon sets, including icon sets that you create yourself. Thanks for watching.